There's a new item in town going by the name of Typhon's Fang. Talking about a mage item here that focuses on lifesteal in combination with power and mana. This item is currently on the Season 5 PTS and will very likely make it into the game, maybe not in its current state though. Let's talk about Typhon's Fang's stats first and then discuss why or why not this item may be very, very powerful at the moment. So Typhon's Fang costs 2,800 gold, quite expensive, almost as much as Rod of Tahuti now after the price decrease. The item has 100 magical power, has 200 flat mana and 15% magical lifesteal. So far so good, high amount of power, decent amount of mana and a decent amount of lifesteal. The interesting part is really the passive though. Your magical lifesteal from items is increased by 50%. Your magical power is increased by the 100% amount of magical lifesteal you have. So this item right off the bat has 2/3 of Rod of Tahuti's buffed power, or rather Rod of Tahuti's changed power in terms of base stats, not exactly a buff, we'll get to that in another video. In terms of mana, it's comparable, it has flat mana, which I do not prefer over MP5, but still the stats kind of end up around the same, at least if you're not staying in lane for too long. As it is only 200 gold cheaper, I would say the items are overall comparable and fulfill to some degree a similar purpose. Just going by the regular stats, excluding the passive, you get 15% magical lifesteal in trade for 50 flat power. A trade-off that can be worth it depending on how well your character works with power, how well scaling on that character is, versus how much use that character can make of lifesteal. Factoring in the passive, the item actually has more than 15% lifesteal though, because the magical lifesteal is increased by another 50%. It's worth noting here that the lifesteal is only increased when it comes to items. Your internal lifesteal that your character might have is not affected by the passive. So realistically, we actually have to talk about 22.5% lifesteal. But then again, we also have to talk about more power for both Typhon's Fang and Rod of Tahuti, as they both have power amplifiers in their passives. There is an important difference between both parts of the passive. We don't know if they will stay that way, that's currently how it is though. The power part is calculated before the magical lifesteal gets amplified through the other part of the passive. So the maximum amount of this is the maximum amount that you can get through your items only without getting 50% on top of that. So if you have 15% lifesteal, then you will only get 15 power from that, and not the additional 7.5% that would bring you to 22.5%. That means you can effectively get 65 extra power if you absolutely max out lifesteal, which is actually possible. In that context, it's worth talking about Rod of Tahuti a little bit. Now I've done the calculation before, I'm gonna do it again briefly here. With how Rod of Tahuti currently works, the average power increase that you will have with that item is 12.5% across the entire health of a target. This doesn't always apply. If you start attacking somebody at half health, that's obviously different, but we can only really speak from a scenario where we factor everything in and just half it. There's also another downside of Tahuti that has been found out, being that if you start dealing damage with something above 50% health, it will not get the amplifier from Rod of Tahuti if it keeps ticking under 50% health. So any dot will not get amplified further after that. Meaning Rod of Tahuti is maybe even a little bit weaker. But let's assume a 12.5% for the purpose of making this as easy as possible. If Rod of Tahuti amplifies your power by 12.5% on average, then the power you would need in total on your items without the amplifier from Rod of Tahuti beforehand to compete with the extra power from Typhon's Fang would be 520 power. This is not something that's easily reached at all. At the same time, it's not easy to reach max lifesteal as well. And this is where things get a little bit ironic. So I can kind of call this part of the video an appeal to please, please, please give us jungle practice on PTS. Because basically I had this whole thing planned talking about a unique item interaction that would be very, very strong if it worked. And I thought it worked because I only had the chance to briefly test it in a PTS conquest match where you kind of have to pay attention to the game still and can't just mess about. And turns out I was mistaken and what I thought would work didn't actually work. I'm still gonna tell you what it was so you know that it doesn't work. But it's a bit unfortunate because that kind of ruins the idea of what this video would have been about otherwise. So the point I would have made here is that there's actually a pretty easy way to reach that lifesteal cap by using Bancroft's Talon. When your health gets lower, you get more power and more lifesteal from Bancroft's Talon, and it looked like this would factor into one part of the passive, not the extra power increase that you get from the lifesteal, but the extra lifesteal increase, meaning if that would have happened, you would have been able to reach 50% lifesteal with max stacked Bancrofts and Fang alone. That would have been pretty strong because you would have been able to just get 75% lifesteal just from two lifesteal items, and I don't think I need to explain how broken that could have been. That's unfortunately not the case. I was mistaken because I was playing Ao Kuang, and I also had the 15% lifesteal from his own passive, which made it look like I reached the cap of 65, which would have been shown. Everything above that probably wouldn't have been shown. So yeah, I kind of baited myself there, and that's not correct. As such, Typhon's Fang is not as busted as I originally thought it was, because with that, you would have been able to reach insane lifesteal values quite easily. There is something that is still worth pointing out and interesting about it though, when it comes to lifesteal and interaction with other items. The current hard cap for lifesteal is 65%, which is already a quite high amount. But if you're building a Typhon's Fang, then the passive of that will be able to go above that threshold. It's not factored into the soft cap basically, but it goes beyond that. As such, you're able to get 97.5% lifesteal if you're building into full lifesteal as a mage. Now the question is, how beneficial is that really? If you would have been able to reach a massive chunk of that with two items, it would have been really, really good. Now it's only so good because you have to keep in mind that most mages at least primarily use AoE abilities, and when you use AoE abilities, there is a factor, a coefficient of 1/3 that you actually lifesteal. So if you had 100%, you'd only steal 33% of that, as it is AoE and would proc too much on minion waves or things like that otherwise. Non-AoE basic attacking mages, on the other hand, can still get a lot of benefit out of these high lifesteal items and this high lifesteal value, and are probably more likely to make use of it. Now, what you will have to remember with lifesteal, on the other hand, is that it is affected by anti-heal. And when we're talking about anti-heal, Divine Ruin got a buff in the most recent patch, or in the Season 5 patch as well. And it was already decent enough to be picked up a lot beforehand, especially in competitive. With this buff to it, it will be picked up even more, and that makes it kind of hard to go through with a lifesteal build when you can't really abuse any mechanics. I still think that certain gods will make use of it regardless of that, especially somebody like Freya, but it's not gonna be for everyone as much as I thought it would be. And with that, we're coming to the end of the topic for today. I do think that Typhon's Fang is still towards the stronger end, and I can imagine many gods picking it over Rod of Tahuti as long as they can utilize it, but it's not quite as broken as I originally thought it would be. Before we close this out, I have a question for you guys though. I would like to hear what in particular you'd like to hear about regarding Season 5. I've heard quite a few propositions already. Obviously, a lot of you want calculations for the items. I will do some of those at the moment. I will do some in the next days for items, especially where I think it would be worth taking another look at them for hires and possibly nerfing them before the season comes out. With the others, I concern myself more after the Season 5 patch actually lands, so I know they won't get changed immediately and the calculation was basically in vain. And then I had some propositions regarding new counter items, or countering the new items in general, countering the newer gods. I think I want to go back to that a little bit, as well as obviously basic guides for the new map and the new stats and everything like that. But I'd like to know if there's anything else you guys would like to see in particular, and I will try to make that happen as well. There's so much stuff to choose from that I'd kind of like to know what you guys want to hear about first before I get too deep into one particular topic when other things may be more interesting. And yes, on that note, the high-risk expo stuff is still coming as well. I just had to put that on hold for a little while. And with that, thank you guys very much for watching. If you are new to the channel, feel free to click the sub button and maybe the bell. It really helps me out. I will drop a casual plug here because I haven't done that in a while. I will be streaming a lot more on Twitch.tv/DukeSloth. Again, I couldn't do that much lately, but now that we've moved, I'm able to do that again. So you'll see a lot more of me there again. Feel free to stop by there. See you for the next one tomorrow. DukeSloth, out. So I actually figured out my demonetization issue, and it was my outro. As such, feel free to click any of the links around here right now. There will be new outro music as soon as I find something nice. Until then, as you guys requested, I will do the outro music myself. You're welcome.